First problem we're going to work on here is called the socks shoes property. Socks shoes property. I'm not going to say it's why it's called the socks shoes property right now, but I'll ask you after we finish it. G is a group. A and B are elements of the group. We're trying to show that the inverse of the product A times B is the product of their inverses, but in reverse order. This is always true. G can be any group. What would the proof of this be? It's a matter of asking yourself, what does it mean to be an inverse? And how would I then verify that? For C to have an inverse, C inverse, when you multiply them in either order, you have to get the identity. Though it can be proved if you multiply them in one of those orders and get the identity, then when you multiply them in the other order, you'll also get the identity. But we can go ahead and verify that these both equal the identity when C is A times B, I guess. And it's inverse. Well, I shouldn't use this symbol for it because I already know that entire symbol represents the inverse of A times B. I'm trying to show this thing is the inverse of A times B. So that's what I better multiply by A times B to see that I get E. For sake of time, I won't write sentences, but here's the idea. A times B, yeah, multiply it times this thing that you're trying to show is the multiplicative inverse. Then you want to use the fact that B inverse is the inverse of B and A inverse is the inverse of A. How do I use that? Step by step. Use the associative property first. That's the associative property. Then you know B inverse is the inverse of B. I can write that. It would be good to show here at the beginning one step of saying, okay, A times E is A. Before we write A times A inverse is E. And yes, it works the other way around too. If I put the B inverse A inverse on the left instead of the right, it's very similar steps. Use the associative property again. A inverse times A is the identity E. B inverse times E is B inverse, and B inverse times B is E. Therefore, the inverse of A times B is B inverse times A inverse, though I am purposely not saying something else that probably should be said here, because I'm wondering if you know it. What else should I say to get to this conclusion? That's one of the theorems in chapter two. What am I really using in going from these two equations to this equation? Starts with the letter U. UN. I always do this in classes. UNI. UNIQ. Unique. Yeah. Uniqueness. Uniqueness of inverses. That's a theorem. The definition of a group says every element has an inverse, but the definition of the group doesn't say inverses are unique. You got to prove that. And it's a theorem that's proved in the book with the cancellation law, actually, meaning you got to prove the cancellation law as well first. So I'm really using that here in showing that the product of these two things equals E and the product of these two things equals E. To conclude that this is true, that the inverse of AB is B inverse A inverse, I'm also using uniqueness of inverses. Now, would you have to quote that if this were exam one? It certainly wouldn't hurt. I probably wouldn't mark it wrong if you didn't, but ideally here at the beginning of the class, it's good to do that. We're done. Praise the Lord. So, why is this called the socks shoes property? When you get dressed, first you put your socks on, then you put your shoes on, right? Not the other way around. Well, most people. So, what do you do to reverse that? What's the inverse of that? Take your shoes off before you take your socks off. Go in reverse order. So, if pretend these are functions and putting your socks and shoes on are like functions, they're operations. B gets done first, work from right to left. Put your socks on before your shoes are on. So B is putting your socks on, A is putting your shoes on, going from right to left. How do you reverse that? The inverse over here, going from right to left, take your shoes off first, then take your socks off. That's why it's called the sock shoes property.